beloved Ascension Pioneers. I was guided to make another video today. Oof, we had a mini ice age yesterday. You know, there sometimes feels like there's four seasons of the year, you know, in just one day. It goes from extreme sunny weather to extreme cold and rain. And I was speaking about these shifts in my previous video. And it's just felt so deeply that sometimes I wonder, who still doesn't feel, you know, this shift and nature showing us how she's shifting? You know, she's rejoicing in all these new colors. Whenever it's sunny again, you know, I just see these new colors outside. And I had this beautiful feeling, you know, this thing happening to me today when I first opened my balcony window, you know, the balcony doors, and I stepped out in the balcony and there's still a lot of cold outside. But the moment I opened the door, there was this push and pull of the energies in my hands, like deep tingling, you know, rushing through me, like this buzzing sensation that I really loved. And I just saw how instantly when I, you know, got out, it was felt. And I was just reading, you know, before, prior to going out, I was reading about all new upcoming events. You know, we have intense solar activity right now, which of course, as always, is opening us up emotionally, causing these emotional purgings to occur within most. And also what's happening, you know, the eclipse is almost here. It's happening on Sunday. And for the whole week, I feel this empty void within me. And this is this vacuum space that is being created through us so we can more, you know, open up to the new. Because we are starting a new template and so many things are gonna change and already are changing. So I wanted to talk about something that I feel is really important. This was just my intro, as usual. But I wanted to talk about this way of the new. Because just a few days ago, I was guided to see this page. A friend sent me a page of someone, of this spiritual teacher, healer, mentor, you know, whatever, doesn't matter. But the moment I saw the page of this person, I was looking deep into it. And I was feeling that I need to speak about this. You know, and then yesterday I saw a video from my Australian light sister speaking about similar things, just in a different way. And I decided, yeah, this is a confirmation that I need to speak about this. You know, how well do we actually observe what is happening in our reality? You know, the moment that I was guided to go to that page, what was there? You know, that was supposed to be a free newsletter of that person. But what was there, you know, waiting for you at that page first when you come was this like huge sign of copyrights. You know, be aware, this is protected by this copyright and I don't know, program. And then another message like this, you know, covering up the whole screen. You know, this is due to this author, copyright, you know, one copyright after another. And, you know, and the sideways of the page were full of commercial and advertising, you know, and these offerings of so many things, you know. And then I go to the Facebook page of that person. And then I see, you know, that actually whatever the person writes, you know, this tiny passage, always, you know, advertising themselves, like, you know, this is a nice way you can connect to me, you can have a session with me, I can do you soul guidance for you, you know, it's like all advertisement. And the moment I saw all of that, I was so repelled, I totally did not resonate, and I just felt really guided, you know, that I need to speak about this. Because, you know, when I saw the number of fans of that page, that always makes me see clearly the objective situation as to how many people still like that way, how many people still follow that way. Especially, you know, I was really, when I'm becoming observant of the signs, they're always presented to me. This is how I objectively observe without, you know, attaching to, you know, because if you're guided to certain pages, everyone will have parts of the truth there. But when you will deeply move into the retrospection, you will see what is there. When you will move into the observation stage of your being, you will see that not all is as shiny as it might seem at the beginning. You know, so when I was guided to see certain aspects, I looked through everything. I was guided to see that there are certain things that are being said by that person that are not even true. You know, for instance, something like the golden age is still not how it's supposed to be. It's going to be postponed for, I don't know, a few thousand years and things like that. And I'm thinking, why is this person feeding people such stuff? Why? You know, because people like to hear what they like to hear. So I see that most people, when I say most, you know, their ascension pioneers know that this is just like just generalizing, because the more that you awaken and you know your vibration is increasing, the more you will also see there's those who are still very much in the deep dark and sleeping in the slumber mode. So I see that there are certain people, and I say most because this is still the, you know, the global state of how we function in this reality, this world. So I know that most of the people still like to be fed with what they like to hear instead of, you know, just truly starting to work on their own selves. So what it said there about the golden age was something like, yeah, so it's not happening yet. It's not, you know, how you think, but, you know, better prepare for the next, I don't know, whatever, I don't know what kind of year date was it given, but it was something like, so you better work on yourself now, you know, and then offering again the advertisement. This is the basic function mechanism of the new age, you know. I get so triggered within that, and I say, how can people not see this? How can people not see that there are certain individuals, first of all, they proclaim themselves as teachers, healers, and mentors, you know, authors. You know, first thing I noticed was the copyright next to the picture. You know, it's like I have a picture of myself too on my webpage, but there's no copyrights there. There's no, this is me, this is my firm, this is my company. It's the way of the old. It's only the way of the old. And it's the way of the, not the entire truth of one, you know? So whenever I see things like that, I ask myself, how can people not see this? It's so obvious, because the basic mechanism of the new age is to make you feel powerless, to make you feel that you need to work on yourself, of course, but through them. You know, they are offering you all their guidance and all their counseling, and you need at least 3 sessions to, I don't know, barely function as a normal human being. It's like, it's so funny, you know. I get in that state of joking, you know, you gotta know who I am in that sense. But it's just so obvious to me. And when I see the number of people following such pages and such people, I say, you know, this is clearly showing me and all of us the state where society is still at. You know, maybe some people are opening themselves more spiritually, but this is the state when they still need, I guess, those people who are making them feel like they can do it alone. And this is where I come in, you know, this is where I'm so different. First of all, I only wish to guide people within so they can connect to their true power. This is a true devotion to divine love that we all are. There's no need to advertise yourself or to make people feel that they need you and that you're their spiritual mentor, counsel, I don't know, whatever, healer, teacher. This is too much, you know, self-proclaimed. You know, for me, there is no teacher, and there's no, you know, teacher and the student are the same. But the moment you proclaim yourself as a spiritual teacher and keep advertising yourself as such, and all of your page is mostly not about your content, what you're saying, but advertisement and copyright sections and, you know, basically saying, this is all mine, this is all mine. But actually, when you speak about something, you're just the messenger. You're the vehicle for the source energy. We all are. So how can I own anything if it's not mine? This is not the way of the new. So when people ask me on my page, hey, can I share this on? This person really needs to hear this or see that. Can I share? I say, whatever, just share. Even if you don't put my name there, I don't care. It doesn't matter where it comes from. If it is the vibration of truth, it doesn't matter where it comes from, because truth just is. So the more that you label yourself and proclaim yourself as this master, guru, teacher, guide, healer, counselor, spiritual mentor, teacher, whatever, there's so many labels. The more that you do that, the more you put yourself in a space of needing to declare yourself as someone to have power over others. But a true spiritual teacher, such as there were here in the times of the past, still are here. But, you know, they're like these grains in the sand, tiny little, you know, and the right people find them because they're aware enough to find them, because it's all about the resonance. So those true teachers were never proclaiming themselves as such, you know, what Jesus was speaking. And you can read about that in the Aquarian Gospel and many other, you know, Gospels, I think, about this, or the Gospel of Mary, or many as such. All these Gnostic Gospels, they show that these people were actually teaching people the basic principles of creation, the basic principles of connecting to your inner source. And none of these things were, you know, put under a price. You know, none of those things were said, you know, because I'm a teacher, you know, you have to come to me and I will advertise myself because I need to do that in order for you to find me and to really know that I'm an authentic teacher. This didn't work like that. within those who really taught the way of the sacred, the way of the wholeness that we are, the way of the source within. So I was just watching this video. I think Lilu Mace put it out there. The interview with Kathleen McGovern. I don't know her name. I have her book here. I'm sorry. I have a book. It's a book of love. Kathleen McGovern. Yeah, I'm right. She was. I have it in Slovene version. I didn't read it yet. My mom read it, but it's about the teachings of Mary Magdalene, you know, and how she was actually encouraged by Jesus to continue the teachings of the sacred, of the holy, of the one source that we all are. And I really like that because it's the simple essence of truth. And truth is so simple. But the more you complicate it, the more you label it, the more you remain in the way of the old. So, you know, we have some teachers who speak about the dimensions, and they speak about the new earth and 5D and the difference with the 3D. But what they do, they're on their own. They do not yet embody this. They don't really move as to function within those ways of the new. We have to first embody the ways of the new. You know, if I'm still within the copyright section, mine, you know, how I felt when I entered that page was like I'm in a prison, you know, warning me of all these restrictions. How is this the way of the new? How is this the way of sharing with everyone globally through love? And nothing belongs to anyone because all belongs to all anyway. So you have those attachments as to mine. This is the ego. You don't have to proclaim yourself as any teacher. People will recognize you as such when you truly are humble, devoted to what you do, and this is to serve the sacred, the holy, the source of all that is. This is who you're serving when you're in this path. So this is the way you have to anchor in the new. So the only way that the way of the new is going to be anchored here on Earth is when we follow it, when we do it, when we embody it, when we take the action steps within it. So if I keep acting within my ego, how will I anchor the new golden age? So of course, the reality of that person is there is no such thing as a golden age because they don't act yet that way. So this is not their reality. But they don't necessarily have to feed everyone else about this truth. Because there are those who are choosing a golden age. There are those who are choosing the way of the sacred and the holy from within. They are taking the conscious steps to truly becoming empowered source beings. So if you're one of those people, which I think you're not because you're watching my videos, but still, you know, the message goes out there. I don't know whoever is going to see it. But if you're one of those people who follows directions from such people, you have to become more observant. Please observe the signs. This is how you're becoming discerning and assertive. This is how you're becoming, you know, in a way that you take your power back. It's in you. It lies in you. No one else. So you don't have to, you know, go to someone else to tell you when is the shift happening. What does the solar eclipse mean? What is, I don't know, what is going to happen astrologically? You know, these are all guidelines, but you don't have to go out there when you start fully connecting with your source from within. This is what I was talking about in my previous video. How to notice the shifts, how to truly flow with the divine, how to go within the path of least resistance. It's all connected to raising your awareness. And when you raise your awareness, you raise your frequency. This is your vibration. And you're reclaiming your power back. You're reclaiming the field of who you are back. So you don't need anyone to do your soul readings. You know, I saw this person advertising and the pricing was... I was just like, how can you put a price tag so high on, I don't know, 30 minutes soul reading? I was like, do you even feel that... I don't know, these are intense times. People don't... They don't just, you know, of course, maybe that's available for rich people, but I don't think, you know, those people, I don't even know how to explain this, but it's just pure nonsense. It's okay to put the value of the energy exchange, and I was speaking about this in one of my videos called Money and Spirituality, and that's okay if you're guiding others, if you're having sessions and all of that. But things like saying, you know, I have, I can see your soul signature and tell people to become more empowered. I can do you this reading so you can be more connected to yourself. It's saying like they can do it. You know, how I operate is I rather show people how to connect with their own soul and read their own blueprints. I don't have any interest in reading their blueprints. Most of these people are even saying stuff that are not even real. You know, you have certain psychics, you know, just yesterday came this magazine that my mom reads, and there was this article from this psychic woman that I, new in my past once. I went with a friend over to see that woman, and she was, I didn't feel her vibration was very high. She was smoking and just drilling these words. And she literally claims that she sees black and white images, and she interprets them, and she tells people what's going to happen. No, these events as to how something's going to happen are not engraved in stone. Certain global cosmic events are, but how we get there, how we fluctuate within that, is our own free will choice and decision. So no psychic can tell us and predict us the future. They're manipulating us in such a way. And these are addictions. You know, there's this woman who writes great articles here, and she always says that this is a part of the addictions too, to be addicted to what a psychic tells you. And just recently, this person asked me that she's explained that she's experiencing some difficulties, and she said, maybe I'm even considering to go see a psychic about this. This is pure example of giving your power away. Why do you feel such a need to feel your future, to know your future? Sorry, mistaken the words. You have to feel your future, but to know your future and the unfoldment of events, you can, because when you're really on a path of ascension, you're taking your power back, you're reclaiming your source abilities, your divine attributes, and you're creating your future. You're co-creating your reality as how you would want it to be. This is the basic point of ascension. So these psychics, they operate in a way, they're good, you know, mind readers. They will tell you what you need to hear. So as long as you're still within this mode of needing to hear something, these people will have power and effect over you. So I think that the people who are really conscious about, you know, choosing their path as that of the sacred will not give the power away to those people, those individuals who will take advantage of that, who will, you know, benefit financially or any other kind of, you know, way of being here through that. So take your power back, reclaim your power, reclaim your source, your source energy, your purity, which will lead, you know, lead you to have doors opening for you everywhere to clearly feel the divine guidance speaking through you. So you don't need anyone to give you your soul reading in a way that, you know, they know your blueprint and you don't, because they're psychic and you're not. When you will connect to those inner realms, you will know everything about you and how the divine works. You will know at the exact right timing. Sometimes we're not allowed to know things because it's not for our highest good, and it's not for the highest good of all concerned. And trust that when it's time to know, you will know it. But you are creating your future. You're not being given data and fact about your future by someone else. For example, when I went to that psychic, that was years ago, because a friend wanted to go, that I, you know, was hanging out back then in my old days. And she told me stuff that none of them is true at all now. Because why? Because I'm not one of those beings. Because beings who still function in 3D reality when they go around in circles, what psychics tell them, because they're so powerless, they literally become true. Because the mind is a powerful tool. And I didn't believe in any of this stuff. So nothing was like she told me at all, at all. So this is how, you know, verified these psychics are. Yeah, they work on those people who still have the mentality for that, you know, to work on them. Psychic energy is not spiritual energy. Spiritual energy is the energy of the heart and the crown, you know, connected together. It is the higher knowing. It is not the seeing or hearing. There are intuitives who are within the purity of working with those energies, but most psychics are not, you know. So drawing information from the astral planes is not the same as having higher spiritual guidance, connection with the highest light of all. So please know that. Please choose your steps wisely. Please observe when these signs are presented to you, you know, when you see those logos or commercials or advertisements. You know, there was even this great example of that, you know, that person having this commercial selling this spray that will take away all the negative energies from your place. How could just one, you know, inch of the spray just make all the negative energies go away? You are the source that is operating and that is manipulating the energy through divine alchemy. You have to become that in order to remember who you truly are, because that is interconnected. So nothing is done just like this, like magic. You know, there's the spray, and you know, that way you think that it's the spray's way. No, it's your mind. These things work through the mind because you believe it to work, it works. You see, but they get money out of it. But you don't have to find that out about the power of your mind through, you know, giving so much money away. And some people do that. Okay, this was my message for today. Become observant. See the signs. They're everywhere. Once you're a conscious observer, they're everywhere. You just got to notice them, okay? Anyway, have a beautiful preparation for the eclipse. The energies are very strong. If you're feeling those empty feelings, welcome them to bring in the new. We're doing just that. Take care. Bye.